Hi guys, this is Delaroy Studios. You're welcome to another episode of Android Programming. We'll be talking about the card view and recycler view in Android. Our card view is another major element introduced in material design. Using card view, you can represent the information in a card manner with a drop, shadow, elevation, and corner radius, which looks consistent across the platform. Card view extends the frame layout and it is supported way back to Android 2.0 downwards. You can achieve good looking UI when card view is combined with the recycler view. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to integrate card view with recycler view by creating a beautiful music app that displays music albums with a cover, image, and title. I'll be moving straight to Android Studio, which is the development environment for this application. In which I'll be explaining how the source file is actually is. In the Gradle script, we'll be talking about the build Gradle, the project, and the model session. In the model app dependencies, we get to talk about the app compat version 7, the support design, and the recycler view version 7, 23.3 upwards. We have the card view for version 7, also 23.3 upwards. I'll be talking about one library called Glide, where we're going to be getting the library from com.getgithub.bumptech/glide 3.7.0. These three dependencies are very, very important for this application. Let's look at the project session. We only have our class path. We're going to be using the class path build Gradle 2.1.0. That's fine. I'll be moving straight to the rest, the layout files of this application. We have the activity main, the album card, and the content main. Let's talk about the activity main, which is the UI of this application. I'll get to look at the initializing rendering library later on. We have the coordinator layout tag, you know, because we'll be using the recycler view. Okay, and inside this coordinator layout, we have the support design widget appback layout, where we assign an ID to it called app bar, where we call the theme overlay app compat dark action bar. Okay, right inside the app bar layout, we have the collapsible toolbar layout. Okay, where we have the content screen, the expandable title margin, and the title margin starts 64 and 48 dps. We also have the layout scroll flags, where we have the scroll to exit until collapsed. Inside this collapsible toolbar layout, we have the relative layout for the layout with an ID wrap content. We have an image view where we assign the ID code to it called backdrop. Okay. We have a linear layout right inside the relative layout with an orientation of vertical, where it houses a text view of an ID called love music and the text love videos. Okay. Another text view, this season top 20 movies. Okay, we can get to change this text right in the string XML. Okay, we have a closing linear layout and also the closing relative layout. We have the support version 7 widget toolbar tag, where we have the layout width and height, match parent, and the height calling from the attribute action bar size. So we have to close the collapsible toolbar layout of this tag, and also we need to close the upper layout that houses the collapsible layout. Okay, and also we include the layout called content main. We get to see this content main afterwards, and we have to close the outer or the parent tag called the coordinator layout. Let's get to look at the design, and afterwards we'll look at the content main XML. Okay, this is how the design will look like, where we have the love music. Okay, this is in top 20. This is going to actually be replaced by a picture, and we have the items, you know, in card layout, not in list format. No. Okay, let's get to look at the content main, which has been included. Okay, it's a relative layout with the layout with an height match parent, and also the context is that's the package of the main activity, and we have the layout activity main as the showing tools. Also, we included the recycler view. This is where we included the recycler view widget from the Android support version 7, assign an ID to it called recycler view underscore bars vertical. Let's look at the album card XML. Okay, this for the card XML. All right, this is a linear layout with a layout written right, match parent wrap content. This is where we included this Android support version 7 widget card view. We assigned an ID to it called card view, where the card view corner radius is 0 dp. We actually didn't add any radius to it. You can decide to add radius to your card view. That's the curved edges of the rectangle. We have the layout emerging 5 dp's and all. The relative layout follows with an image view called thumbnail, okay, where you scale the type fits x and y. Also a text view with an ID called title. This is going to add the title and the text view, another text view for the count of the music in the album, and another image view that actually hold the overflow image, like three dots, you know, called from the drawable IC dots. The relative layout closes, and also the card view widget also closes, and the outer linear layout closes. Let's get to look at the design view if it is available. Okay, these are the card view with seats for the first layout and also for the list views. All right, that takes us to our drawable. We'll be looking at different pictures, different album covers, you know, from Maroon 5, the Pussycat Dolls. We have another for The Simple Plan. We have another for Sugar Ray, Bon Jovi. We have for The Curries. We have for the Cranberries, rather. We have for Westlife, the Black Eyed Peas, Coldplay, the Viva La Vida, okay, the Cardigans, and so on. Okay, we'll get to look at the Java classes, where we have the album, the album's adapter, and the main activity. The main activity is the UI of the application, and as well, almost all the logistics. We have to import the app bar layouts, just like we did in the way in the XML, the collapsible toolbar layout, the app compact layout, activity, the default item animator, the recycler view, the toolbar, and also we imported glide. All right, the main activity extends app compact activity, where we created the recycler view, the adapter, and the album list. I want create method sets the content view based on the activity main XML, where we instantiated the toolbar, calling its ID, and get set support action bar, passing the toolbar object as the parameter. We call on the init collapsible toolbar method. We get to look at this method afterwards. We pass in values to the recycler view also, and also to the adapter and to the album list. Now let's look at what we did to the recycler view. We instantiate the recycler view layout manager based on the new grid layout manager, which is this class, passing an integer called 2. Now this recycler view object, we set the layout manager. We set item decoration, instantiating the grid spacing item decoration, and also set in item animator, instantiating the default item animator, and set its adapter also. Now let's look at the innate collapsible toolbar. This will show and hide the toolbar title on scroll. That's what this is actually going to do, calling the collapsible toolbar layout and set the title to empty while scrolling. So it's going to hide and show the title when toolbar expanded and collapsed. That's what I was doing. So we're going to add a few album for testing. This is going, we have to set an array for the covers, where we call in the albums, the pictures I showed earlier, these albums, okay? And we need to set some text to it, the title rather, the Sugary, the Bon Jovi, the Curries, the Cranberries, Westlife, Black Eyed Peas. We actually set the titles, and we are the recycler view item decoration. We're going to give equal margin around grid item. That's the grid spacing decoration that extends recycler view item decoration. We created span count, spacing, include edge. Now this is actually going to give spacing to the cards so that they won't be modeled up. Let's look at the album class. Okay, these actually have three private fields, the name, the number of songs, and the thumbnail. Okay, we have the constructor passing three parameters, the name, number of songs, and thumbnail. We created and instantiated with these particular attributes, and we have to get the name and set. That's the get and set method, and get the number of songs and set also the number of songs we get the thumbnail and set the thumbnail. We should be very familiar with this get and set method in encapsulation. Okay, we have the albums adapter. Okay, this actually extends the recycler view adapter. Where we have the my view order that extends recycler view order. Okay, we have the constructor for it, and it set the title, the count, the thumbnail, and the overflow respectively to its ID. We have the albums adapter that calls on the M context and the album list, the generic album list, and set it to its appropriate attributes as well. Okay, we have the unbind view order. You know, this is going to load album cover using Glide library. You know, that's where the picture is being loaded, the cover from the thumbnail. You know, this is going to get the thumbnail method. Okay, we have the show pop-up menu. You know, this is going to show up the pop-up menu when tapping on three dots. Now the three dots beside, okay, where it's going to call the menu album, okay, and we have the my menu item click listener on it. Now the click listener for pop-up menu items that we talked about up there, okay, this is my menu click listener that implements pop-up menu on menu item click listener. Okay, this when you're going to add to favorite the particular album, you know, you're going to have to favorite or you play next. You can extend more on these as source file. This is just like a basic, you know, right? For this is an introduction to recycler view and also card layout. You can add a click listener to this, whereby you can call intent, call other classes to handle different clicks and forward the details right inside the intent to other activity, you know, so that you get a smooth flow of the intent changing activity from each other. I will be going straight to the Android manifest, where I only have my launcher activity as the only activity being called, as the only intent also being called, and I have my package card view. Okay, I'll be uploading this source file to my GitHub account, and also I'll be showing this in an Android emulator for you to see the flow of our recycler view and the card view intertwined together. So stay tuned. Here we go with the application. Can you notice our card layouts are with a collapsible tool, coordinator layout? Right there we have the card layout that listed the different album cover for each album. You scroll upwards, we get us more lists. And can you notice it has actually folded up and have a bar layout showing up with the cards flipping for each one of the albums. Okay, this for the Cranberries, the Westlife, Black Eyed Peas, Viva La Vida. Okay, let's get to click the more button. Okay, we have option to add to favorites or we play next. Okay, we click on play next. We get it's just a toast message anyway. Okay, so we can decide to also add to favorites, you know, but basically we're talking about the recycler view, which actually brings out this list format and the card view, you know, that actually works in form of a grid view. This is material designs whereby the use of grid view, it's been you know, people that you actually don't use the grid view anymore. You use the card view to display text or to display an input, a text field, a list field, and also you have the recycler view to actually make it look smooth and highly presentable. Thank you very, very much for hanging out with me throughout this tutorial, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Have a wonderful time. Bye-bye.